I am going to talk to you the subject called Deliverance Night Prayer Against the Power of Stagnancy. Deliverance Prayer Night Against the Power of Deliverance. And I'm going to read from the book of Isaiah 10, verse 27. The book of Isaiah 10, verse 27. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit this word into you. I commit the message into you, God. I pray that God Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, hallelujah, my God, thank you for this message, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I destroy any destruction. Anything that you want to steal this message shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Lord, I bleed the blood of Jesus over this message. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Isaiah 10, verse 27, the Bible says, and it shall come to pass in that day that is burden shall be taken away from off the shoulder, and his yoke from off the neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. It shall come to pass, it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away. Your burden is going to be taken away from your shoulder. The yokes from your neck, it's going to be destroyed in Jesus' name. The Lord Almighty is going to destroy every burden that you have been having. Every problem, every sickness you've been carrying, the Lord is going to destroy in Jesus' name. Because of the anointing, the Lord is going to destroy every burden, every yoke you have been carrying, every sickness you have been suffering. God is going to take it away in Jesus' name. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 53, verse 1 and 4 to 5, the Bible says, who had believed our report? And to whom is the hand of the Lord revealed? For himself bore our iniquities and carried out sorrows. He was wounded for our rebellions, he was crushed for our sins. He was pushed so that he was punished so that we could have peace. And we received healing from his wounds. So the Bible is asking, who can understand, who can believe our report? Who can believe our report? And to whom is the hand of the Lord revealed? Who can believe our report? As long as you believe the report of Jesus Christ, the report of God, you will be healed. Jesus Christ himself bore our iniquities, our infirmities. He carried our sorrow. Our sorrow, your pain, you have been suffering, you have been thinking, you have been crying, but the sorrow you are in, God has taken it away from you. He was wounded for our rebellious acts. He was crushed for our sins. He was punished so that we could have peace. And we received healing from his wounds. So we are going to be healed. Our pocket is going to be healed in the name of Jesus. There are physical yoke, sickness, diseases, infirmity, health issues, mental yokes, depression, fear, financial yoke, debt, poverty, thieves, family yokes, children on drugs, rebellious, teenager, marriage problem. All these are yokes, and the Lord Almighty is going to break them into pieces. Financial yokes. Debt is a bad problem. When you want people's money, debt is a bad problem. The Lord is going to break it. It is going to destroy it. Remember the Isaiah, what Isaiah was saying. God is going to break and destroy and cancel every debt. The Lord is going to destroy every mental yokes. The Lord is going to destroy every depressed and fear. The fear people are in right now, The Almighty God is going to destroy them. That is what the Bible says, because of the anointing. And tonight, every storm, anything that you have been facing, any problem, the Lord Almighty is going to destroy them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes, we thank God. Physical yokes, sickness, diseases, infirmity, health issues, the Almighty God is going to destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will stop every sickness and diseases in your body in the name of Jesus. Poverty, thieves, the enemy is a liar. Thieves, the thief who comes to steal from you. The thief come in the spiritual world. They come and steal things while you are sleeping. You see your purse is gone. You see things are missing and when you are sleeping. That means that the enemy is putting poverty in you, and him is going to get rich, and you grow poverty every day. That's why you see many people, they have financial difficulty because of these thieves who comes to steal your poverty, your money, your wealth. I command them by the power and the blood of Jesus, according to the Bible, they will be destroyed. No more thieves to come and steal. The enemy that is coming to steal from you, the Bible says they will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I'm going to read from you the book of Deuteronomy 1, verse 40 and 45 to 46. The Bible says, "But as for you, turn around and set out toward the desert along the route to the Red Sea. You came back and wept before the Lord, but he paid no attention to your weeping and turned deaf ear to you. And so you stayed in Kadesh many days at the time you spent there. So here is the spirit of stagnancy. When somebody is having a spirit of stagnancy, he can stay in one place round, round, round without coming out. It is when you cannot point anything tingling you have achieved with your life. It is when you stand at a crossroads, not knowing what to do or where to turn. It is staying at a certain bus stop, meaning staying where you are. Your life is the same now as it was last year. It is like you are drafting on the ocean of life. It is become shepherdness even when you have a shepherd. You have a pastor, you have a pastor church, you go, but it is not working for you. You give your tithes, you give your offering, but it's not working for you. When you are having this spirit of stagnancy, you do things your own way. You would not allow leaders to guide you. With fear and urgency in your heart, you pray with a sincere heart before the Lord. You will discover the secret you ought to know about your life. With sincerity in your heart, he easily reveals secret to you. In your dream, he will show you the operation of the spirit of Kadesh Barnea against your life. When you began to dream, if you are seeing dead relatives, if you are going back to your primary school, you call it primary school, if you are going back to the old house you once lived, if you are wearing holy clothes you used to wear when you were young, if you are going back to your birthplace, or if you see yourself praying with your kindergarten prayer mates, this means there is something, some evil spirit that wants to return you to the beginning of the journey of life all over again. It is the spirit of Kadesh Barnea. That is the stagnant spirit. You see yourself climbing a mountain and yet not going anywhere. If you see yourself in a vehicle without a driver or a steering wheel, if you are loose in the wilderness, and your wonder only return you to the same holy spots. If you find yourself in a particular place or a building you really do not know in the physical world, if you are experiencing your way and then you have dream, it is preventing the good coming your way. If you are experiencing some overpower force always press you down or oppressing you. If you are experienced talking taking some exam you had already passed years ago. If you see yourself in your former primary and secondary school, you must declare war on the power that hindering you, the power of stagnance. We are going to pray tonight that this power must die, must be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. The power of stagnancy that make people to circle, go round, like what happened to Kadesh Barnea, where the children of Israel started round, because of the rebellious, because of what they didn't obey God. They were always going back to worship idols. So God was very angry with them. That's why the Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy, they wept, they did everything, but God was not able to answer them. It's the same thing. So you have to check yourself. You have to check yourself. The Bible says here in the book of Deuteronomy, the Bible says they cried, Deuteronomy 1, 40, 45, and 46. The Bible says, but as for you, turn around and set out towards the desert along the route to the Red Sea. You came back and wept before the Lord, but he paid no attention to your weeping and turned a deaf ear to you. And so you stayed in Kadesh many days at the time you spent there. So you know the story of the children of Israel. When Moses went to get the Ten Commandments, he left them with Aaron. And when he came back, he found them worshiping idols, the calf. And they were dancing, worshiping that, the image, the idols. God was very angry. So the problem started there. God was not with them. They started having some problem. Even they died. Moses himself even killed some, beat them, and he was very angry. He break the commandment. Moses was very angry when he found his own brother Aaron, the priest, worshiping the idols. And instead of telling the people Moses is coming to encourage the people, he went ahead and started worshiping the idols. So things backfired and they started going round, the spirit of stagnance. But God of mercy, God who is massive God, who loves us all through, he is full of mercy. So he again helped them and started reading them again and forgive them. So when your situation, as I've said, when your situation is like that, the Lord Almighty will deliver you. The yoke is going to be broken. The yoke is going to be removed from your shoulder in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that tonight God will help you and take away every situation that you are facing, everything that you are facing tonight. God is going to destroy in Jesus' name. Every power prolonging stagnancy in your life, I command them to die in the name of Jesus. Anything that is prolonging, any power prolonging stagnancy in your life, I command them to die. That's why you see a person come all the way from Africa to come and get a good job, to get money to help the family. Now the stagnant demon and the demon of Kadesh Barnea followed the person, and it makes the person take him long time to achieve something. Some people, it take long time to be healed. Some they take just instantly. Just when I speak the word, before I say amen, they are healed. Some they take them long time. Why? We pray that God, any power that make that problem to be prolonged, I destroy them, I command them to die. Like now you need money and you have been praying, you want something to be done. But the demon of Kadesh Barnea is delaying you. This demon of stagnancy is delaying you. You can't get your breakthrough. I command them, every power prolonging poverty in your life, I command them to die. I am speaking to them right now in the name of Jesus. Every power that wants you to waste your destiny, I command them be wasted. Let them be wasted in the name of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, any power that wants to waste your destiny, wants to waste your time, wants to waste you, let them be wasted in the name of Jesus. Every arrow fired into your head to return, fired to your head, I command them to return to square one. You know there's power that fired to you, then you become, you return to square one. You were in front, you have been doing good, you have been doing very good, and then suddenly everything goes, you remain without anything. You lose everything. So you return again to square one. I command them to go back to the center. You have seen people with houses, with the cars, with good job, and then suddenly you find somebody losing the house, lose everything. Suddenly, I command that demon to go back to the center and destroy the center in Jesus' name. We have to stop this. You have to stop this. You yoke of Kadesh Barnea, that is in your life, that is in your family, I command them to break. Break it in Jesus' name. I command you to be broken in Jesus' name. That powers that is working in your life, there are two powers called stagnancy. They are the powers of Kadesh Barnea. When they are there, they make you that you cannot move. Now I break those power in Jesus' name. Every vehicle of stagnancy in your life, I kill you today in the name of Jesus. I am speaking to you to die and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every stronghold binding you to Kadesh Barnea, I command them to die. Anything that is binding you, the strong man that is binding that you've been rounding, it has been taking long time, even healing. It has taken long time. They were the children of Israel. They rounded the place 40 days. 40 years. In the place which was they were supposed to go 40 days or 11 days, it makes them 40 years. That is serious. That is what is happening to you. The healing, you are supposed to get healed. But now it is taking a long time without being healed. I am speaking to that demon. I'm speaking to that strong man that is rebelling against the word of God. Let it be destroyed in Jesus' name. You have been looking at job for a long time. That you are people comes and get job, you have not get job. I command that power to get out of your life tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. You powers of failure, frustration, and backwardness, I command you to die in the name of Jesus. Let those power to die. You know the powers of failure, frustration, and backwardness. You find that you are so frustrated. You are a failure. There are those powers, stagnance. They make you to fail. They make you frustration. They make you frustrated. You are frustrated so much. Some of them, they think of committing suicide. That's what can make them happy. My son was telling me, he was praying for a lady. This lady, she was confessing that she wants to die. She has nothing. She better die so that she can get away from the problem. Dying is not the solution, because when you die, you go to hellfire and then you start banished. The punishment starts right there. Now, because of this, but God loves you and He will stop this problem if you give yourself to Him in the name of Jesus. May the power that find you pairing in the journey of life come upon your life in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that let God find you in Jesus' name. Desert arrows fired against you. I command them to go back to the sender. Backfire in Jesus' name. There is powers of desert arrows fired to people. When these desert arrows fired to people, the people will be wonder. They don't know. They wonder so much. You can be praying, cursing out demons, and the demons are firing from the forest. So let those arrows go back to the sender in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, cut off every unbiblical cord still attached to Satan. Any biblical cord still attached to Satan, let it be destroyed. Let it be cut off. Any ladder, anything that is giving the devil access to cramp to your body, to cramp to you, I cut them off in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Jesus. Every bondage of sacral spirit, break in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I command them to break in Jesus' name. I pray like this. I would throw my name from the book of born for nothing in the name of Jesus. If you can say, I would throw my name from the book of born for nothing in Jesus' name.
From the book of born for nothing in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. You withdraw your name from the book of born of nothing. You were not born nothing. You were born with something. So the enemy wants you to be without anything. So I destroy that power in Jesus' name. You shall get to your destination at the appointed time in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. Yes, my God. You shall not take a long journey to your inheritance in the name of Jesus. Every power prolonging your stay in the wilderness, I command them to die in the name of Jesus. Every witchcraft agenda for your destiny, I kill you now in the name of Jesus. This is the prayer the witchcraft, they don't want to hear. When you mention like that, it tormented them so much. Every witchcraft agenda for your destiny, I kill you now in the name of Jesus. Every local cadessa, prania, I kill your power in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, let the anointing of the Holy Spirit break every yoke, backwardness in your life in Jesus' name. I am praying that let the anointing of Holy Spirit break every yoke of backwardness in your life in Jesus' name. Every yoke of backwardness, let it be broken in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, I thank you, Father. I frustrate every demonic arrest over your spiritual man in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Let the blood of Jesus remove any unprogressive rebel from every aspect of your life in Jesus' name. I am praying for you, and you have to say amen, because this is agree. That is what is happening right now. And breakthrough decrees be revoked in the name of Jesus. I pray that anti-progress decrees be revoked in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, destroy every satanic garment in your life. The satanic garment, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, destroy every satanic garment in your life. That garment of Satan. Satan has put you. You have no idea. The satanic garment they put on you. Now, when you wear that satanic garment, Satan will do you anything they want because you wear their garment. So I command that garment to catch fire in Jesus' name. Yes.
Amen.
You, the enemy of your career, be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. There is enemy of your careers.
Amen.
So they have taken your career. You have papers, university degree, but they have taken your career. So you don't like your career. You want to change, you change. Still, when you change this, they come and take it. Then they leave you with nothing. So I command them by the power and the blood of Jesus to be paralyzed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes, every evil word spoken in your hometown against your family, backfire. There is some words, some wicked they can speak against your family from your town where you come from. They are wicked people who have very bad mouth, very bad. They are cursers. You know, the Barak hired Baal to curse. So they can curse you. They say, wherever you go, nothing will happen to you, God. So they will curse you, and then it works. That's why you need to break them. Many people, those are the words that are affecting them. We break them and we send them back to the sender in the name of Jesus Christ. You shall reach your goal whether anybody says about you or no. Whether the devil says yes or what. Jesus said, yes, it will come to pass. There's a song which says, when Jesus said yes, it is, that is it. When Jesus said no, that is it. So let anyone, any enemy that has said you will never achieve anything, let them be destroyed and be disgraced in Jesus' name. You will achieve in Jesus' name. Every power magnetizing you to pattern of conviction, I bury you alive today in Jesus' name. You pattern of conviction, turning you back at the gate of your breakthroughs. Enough is enough. Die in the name of Jesus. Every circle of conviction operating in your life, break in the name of Jesus. Every lying tongues against you, roast by fire in Jesus' name. Any evil lying planted in anybody's heart against you, be melted by fire in Jesus' name. I am speaking, let them be melted in Jesus' name. Any satanic agenda against, any satanic agenda that has ever lied against you, I command them to receive angelic slap, receive divine hammer, and die in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every family fountain chasing away your helpers, I command them to dry up by fire. There are some powers from your family chasing away your helpers. When you get help, a person who wants to help you, if you are always, for example, you get a partner, a husband, a wife, somebody who come to help you, and then these powers, they chase them away. You find somebody changing. So you can't have even friend. You can't have anybody around you. They want you be to isolated and be alone like that. Loneliness all the time. Those powers, they must die. They must get out in the name of Jesus. Many people, that's why they're miserable. They're alone. They don't want you to have any friend. When you get somebody who is close to you, wants to help you, they come and take it away. They chase away. And you have not done anything. Lord, pour your anointing to favor upon the life of this person, the life of this man, the life of this woman, in Jesus' name. Every power attacking your blessings day and night, vanish in Jesus' name. Every power that is attacking your blessing day and night, they don't want to see you any blessings. They are monitoring you. When the blessings comes at night, they take it. Blessings come during the day, they are blessing. I command them to vanish in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh God, arise and give this person anointing of the winners in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every hidden curses of evil pattern writing upon the horse of your destiny, I pull you down by fire in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name. Every rearrangement of your destiny through the curses of evil pattern be reversed by fire in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. I bring this person to you, Lord, to begin to follow divine pattern for your life from today in Jesus' name. Every evil pattern of slaves, every evil pattern of slavery in your family, I command them to die. You know there's pattern of slavery. You go every time you work nothing. You are a slave. Even you are married, your husband turned you to be a slave. Wherever you go, they work you like a slave. They pay you little, but you do a lot. That power must die in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. Yeah. Jesus, we thank you, Lord. You refuse to work. You refuse to work like elephant and eat like an ant. That's a power. You work so hard. Like you work like elephant, but you eat like an ant. I command those power to be destroyed in Jesus' name. You've seen how people, they work so much, but they eat like an ant. Let those power be destroyed in Jesus' name. Lord, let all your problems become your promotion. Every problem you are facing, let it turn to become promotion in the name of Jesus Christ. Every pattern of restlessness and slavery in your foundation, I break them in Jesus' name. I break them, I destroy them, I bind them, I render them powerless in Jesus' name. My Father and my God, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name. I pray that God, these people that every prayer that I have prayed for them, Lord, let them come alive and let them manifest to them in the name of Jesus. I commit them to you, Lord, my Father. I pray that every demon of stagnancy, let it die Let them go away from their life in the name of Jesus. Kadesa Tania, I destroy you in the name of Jesus. I command you that power that make people stagnant. They make people to stay in one place. They round, no progress. They are the same every year. They never move anywhere. You are a liar. I destroy you in Jesus' name. I pray for those who are sick. The sickness has refused to go. They are on the chair. They are on the bed. They are on the wheelchair. They are there all the day. Many years, months and months, they are still there. I destroy them. Pains in the nails, pains in the legs, pains in the back, pains in the neck, pains in the hands. I destroy them. Arthritis, I destroy you. Headache, I destroy you. Highs, I destroy you. In the name of Jesus Christ, every pain in your body, I am talking to them. I command them to be melt in Jesus' name. I destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will heal you. Remember Jesus took our infirmity and he has healed us. Therefore, you must be healed in the name of Jesus. You must be healed because Jesus already has healed you. In the name of Jesus, every stubborn demon that does not want to obey the word of God, any demon that is operating in you, that has refused to go, let it go in Jesus' name. Yes, yes. In that he was punished so that we could have peace and we receive healing from his wounds. So any sickness, Jesus was punished. Jesus was wept. Jesus was nailed. Jesus was punished because of healing, because of his wounds to be healed. You should be healed in Jesus' name. Any demon, any witchcraft sickness in your body, that doctor does not know what to do, I destroy them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Any stubborn sickness in your body, I see somebody having chronic sickness. This sickness does not want to go. You have done everything now. You say, let me live with it. I command that sickness to die, to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. You will start walking straight. You have been in that chair for a long time. You have been in that bed for a long time. You will start walking again. I don't know if Patricia is on the line. I pray that Patricia, you shall go to see your wedding, your daughter's wedding. You will be healed. All those pains or sickness in your body has been melted by fire in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you that God, you touch this woman. You are a God who is a God of justice. You are so faithful and you are a massive God. You are so good God. You will touch them, Lord, tonight. You touch everyone who is having sickness that has taken long time to be healed. I command them to be healed in Jesus' name. I am speak to HIV, AIDS, in the name of Jesus. You demon, get out of this person in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There was my daughter, one of my daughter from States. She went to the HIV test for her work. She's a military. She was afraid. She called me. She said, pray for me. I said, no, there's nothing. It is good. Everything is going well. Now when the result came, she was happy. She said, oh my God, this is negative. I said, yeah, it's negative. Those are demons. Demon, HIV is demon. It's a demon. It's a witchcraft demon. Therefore, I curse it from the roots in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Anyone who is listening to these videos, that spirit of HIV AIDS, it has been furnished in Jesus' name. Diabetic, it has been destroyed. High blood pressure, go in the name of Jesus. Rip these people in the name of Jesus. I fire you. I command you to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. You don't have to go to that problem all the time. And Jesus has paid. Jesus, he was Christ. He was crushed for our sins. He was punished so that we could have peace and we could receive healing from his wounds. So you don't have to go through that pain and sickness all taking so long without being healed. Tonight is a night of healing. Receive your miracles in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. We are on tomorrow night. No meeting in the morning. We don't have any meeting in the morning until Thursday. Thursday we will have morning, but morning we don't have, because I see people calling me 8 o'clock. Some who are trying to call, but we don't have any. The prayer line will be on, and the Periscope. So we don't use Ustream anymore. We are using Periscope and prayer line. So you come and invite people to come to prayer line. Give them the number. Invite your friends in Periscope. God bless you so much. See you again midnight. Midnight is the best prayer that you can attack your enemies. It doesn't matter from other countries. This is the time that we are praying and we are attacking them. What they have been doing, we stop them in Jesus' name. Those prayers, these videos will be up. You can replay. You can listen again and again. It is going to be on YouTube tomorrow. On our website, it is going to be there. And I think this video is going to deliver so many people. God bless you so much. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow night, midnight, the same time. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.